for July, you've got your strength focused. Our first exercise on your list is the wide squat. So, take feet out nice and wide, as the name suggests. You want it to be roughly two shoulder widths apart at its narrowest point. So ideally, two shoulder widths. If you can, a little bit further. Really depends on the flexibility of your hips and the strength of your adductor muscles. So, toes are pointing out slightly. Whichever way your toes are pointing is the direction that your knees are going to bend. So, push the toes out slightly, weight through the heels, squat down nice and low, and then lift the body back up in your wide squat. With me, I'm doing a slightly different version for this routine. I'm going to keep my base of support slightly narrower so it puts a bit less pressure through my pelvic floor. I'm going to stick with a standard bodyweight squat. Next exercise on your list is your tricep dips. So if you don't have anything that you can prop yourself up on, or if you don't have quite enough space in the objects that you can use, we can do it on the floor. So you have your hands behind, fingers are pointing straight forward, pull the shoulders right back and lift the chest, and then lift the hips. Then from the elbows, push the elbows backwards, keeping the weight pressing all the way through the palms and the hands. If you want a little bit more, I'm just using blocks. You can use a step, you can use the bottom of your stairs, you can use your sofa, whichever feels best to you. The straighter you have the legs, the more resistance it is for your arms. So it's more difficult for you to control that shoulder movement. So you've got to keep your shoulders away from your ears and pulled right back. Next one on your list, your reversing lunge. So if you want to increase the burn, then you stick with one side and then you change. So with your reverse lunge, you're stepping back, we're aiming for 90 degrees at each knee, stepping forwards. You can either alternate, or you can do all of your repetitions on one side first, and really fire up through the glutes as you step. Choice is yours on that one. Next one on your list is your press-up. So, options. We want the hands nice and wide. You can either come to a box press-up, so you have hands under shoulders, in line with shoulders, knees underneath the hips and the back is flat, and you push down and up from here, flexing at the hips. We can have you on your knees, leaning forward, so that you push from here, or you can come further in your press-up, onto the toes, leaning forward, belly nice and strong as you drive the body up. Next one on your list is your deadlift. So this is where you will need a bit of resistance. So ideally a bar with plates on each end, or you can use, like we said before, a broom with two carry bags. Fill them up with bottles of water, something like that, just to give you a little bit of weight to lift. Make sure you pick up the bar with a straight back, hands, thumb width outside the hips, shoulders back and down. Now with a deadlift, the movement comes from the hips, not from the back. The back stays completely straight, pushing the chest forward, sticking your hips back, belly stays nice and strong, and we're aiming to come down to roughly knee or mid-shin level. It depends on your own flexibility. Now I'm doing this as mainly deadlift with a slight bend in the knees, just to give the knees a little bit more support. If you have the hamstring flexibility, you can do it with straight legs. It's entirely your choice on that one. I've put it into your program for it to focus more on glutes and lower back rather than backs of the legs. If you have your knees straight, it's more about backs of the legs. If you have your knees slightly bent, it's more glutes and lower back. So you choose, maybe alternate it, see which one works better for you. Next on your list, single leg lateral raise. So again, shoulders back and down. Elbows are slightly flexed, and we're bringing the arms wide, level with the shoulders. Keep breathing smooth and steady. The higher you hold your leg, the more work it's going to be for that leg. So I think that really depends on how you're feeling by the time you've got to this routine. You then change, and we do the other side. Now I'm going to take you through last one on your list is your toe reach. So the legs are all the way up into the sky. Draw the belly button in, both hands curling from the rib cage, trying to lift your shoulders and bring your full body up towards your toes. Now for me, I've got to add in the option. I'm resting back on my forearms. I'm going to have my legs up, and I'm going to lift my chest and then push back down. So it's a movement from the spine and the shoulders, as opposed to trying to lift all the way up to reach the toes. So, now I'm going to take you through the full routine so you can see what it's like when you perform one set, and if there's any adaptations that I need to make along the way, you'll be able to see them. They will obviously be pregnancy adaptations, you don't necessarily need to follow those, but from a point of view of your lower back, if you have any kind of disc or lower back issues, then sticking with the pregnancy options is actually the best way for you to go. So, let's see how it goes. Thank you. July. We've got your July toner. Now, obviously, I've had to put in a few extra options in there for me, but if you can, I want you to try and stick to the full range of the various different exercises. As always, we'd love to hear how you get on with our workouts. So if you can, as always, we'd love to hear how you get on with our workouts. So if you have any feedback, if you have your own stories to share about how your workout has been, please do get in touch. Share your feedback either on YouTube or send us an email, and it would be lovely to hear from you.